Good morning friends, I am Suraj Agrawal and you are watching your favorite YouTube channel Gardening is my passion. Today friends, I am telling you an excellent totally free of cost fertilizer, insecticide, soil amendment, everything you can get free of cost, and these are excellent resource of calcium, potassium, phosphate, a resource of aluminium and trace elements. These are the wood ash. And wood ash are easily you can get it from your home. Just you can burn a few pieces of wood and you can get this wood ash. And I tell you, this is a resource of various minerals you see in the screen. And lots of minerals are here. And that too in free of cost. Calcium, potassium, silicon, manganese, potassium, aluminium, sulfate. Everything you can get free of cost. Just burn a few pieces of wood and get the wood ash and just sieve it properly to get the dust from here, from the below. After getting the dust, you just collect it and you can save it for the future use. And these are the wood ash I have collected after sieving it properly. Just see how I have burnt it, and totally I have collected the burnt wood ash from there. And after it, I have sieved it properly. And now I am showing you the 10 best uses of this fertilizer. These are rich source of macro and micronutrients. All are calcium. And if your tomatoes are not growing well, tomatoes are not getting a good size, good quality, and calcium, potassium, and these plants are not flowering, the source of potassium you can use. If the containers are around 10 inch or more, you can use 1 teaspoonful in one container or pot in once in a month. Once in a month, you can apply 1 teaspoonful in 10 inch or above. Or if the container is very small, below 10 inch, 5 or 6 inch, you can use 1/2 inches. So this is the small container. I am using 1/2 teaspoonful of this ash from here. And now sprinkle in the soil, and I am showing you how to apply it in your plants, and there are beautiful benefits. This is a very good acid neutralizer, and if your soil are getting acidic and productivity is very, very much hampered, so you can amend it by applying this. This is a very good alkaline compound product. You can apply it and all your compound. And third is, if the plants, your container is full of mosses, you have severe problem of moss problem, you can sprinkle this ash on these mosses and no mosses will grow. So you can solve the moss problem here. And if the plants are getting fungal rotting problem, you can apply this on these plants where the fungal rotting is there. So you can control check the fungal problem also with this ash. This is a beautiful fungicide you can apply. And if there are insect infestation in your plants, fruit plants here, you just sprinkle all above the plants here, sprinkle around totally. And after one day, you can just wash it properly so that they remove. Otherwise, what will happen? The leaf burn will occur. So you sprinkle it and insect will go away from it. New beautiful this insecticide you can apply. And after one day, you can just rinse it properly, rinse it off to remove all the ash from the leaves of the plants, and else the plant's leaf will burn. So this is a beautiful insecticide, pesticide. You can apply it, and the rest is a beautiful resource of nutrients. And if there are in the garden your plants are fungal attack severely, you see this is kind, and if you apply this one, so sprinkle this one, and the fungal rotting will be amended totally, and the plants will also get a beautiful source of calcium and potash, and they will beautifully grow the flowers also. Lots of flowers will come in these plants also. So this is also beautiful flowering agent. And all the charcoals that are left after sieving it, you can apply it in the cactus succulent mix, or in orchids, or in adenium, or in roses also. You can use this as well as a soil mix it with the soil, and the potting soil mix will be nice. If the adenium or succulent or cacti or orchid, they are the best potting mix for this succulent and cacti. And next, this is a very, very excellent thing. You to recharge your compost, you apply 1 teaspoonful in your compost, and that will boost up your total compost, and the compost uptake of compost and amino acid and this all this fulvic acid and everything will be uptake after can buy these plants easily if you apply this small amount of this ash, and your total compost will be boosted up, charged up totally with this, and your compost will work twice or thrice good and excellent there. And if you want, you can apply directly also this kind of ash in the plants. But one thing you remain mind that you can apply in once in a month, not much doses. If you apply much doses, you can the soil may be alkaline and your plants product will be highly hampered. So you have to apply very, very cautiously once in a month, and that too in a 1 teaspoonful only, not more than that. This is one. Next, if your garden is full of snails and slugs, you have to check the snails and slugs. You can apply this one, and the snails and slugs do not like to run on this, so they will be checked totally. This is also a very nice soil amendment for your potted plants. Potted plants, if the soil is very, very hard, you can apply this, and the potted plants will be very, very nice. And if there is any frost problem in area, just sprinkle this ash on this plant, and the plants will be safe from the frost next year. So this is the totally area beautiful for applying this. And one thing you must remain in mind, you cannot use it in roses or azaleas or rhododendron or potatoes or blueberries or these kinds of plants. Those plants which do not like alkaline soil, who loves acidic soil, you cannot use them, because this ash can make your soil alkaline. So the productivity may be highly diminished or highly hampered. So this is all from today for these 10 best uses of this ash or wood ash, and you can preserve it for your future use also. Hope you like this video. If you at all like this video, please give it a like, give it a thumbs up. If you want to share, please share with your near and dear ones. If you are very new to my channel, please subscribe my channel. I'm going to give you a lot about the garden tips and tricks and all. Thank you very much. Thank you for being with us. So nice of you.